Doing Zoom stuff, if they end up not being able to do anything, they can come up to the class, do a class of their team. So if they miss this schedule, they can make it up at the class. So propaganda comes out of Israel, right? It's a close contact. Edie looked to put it together. He took different martial arts and kind of put them together that was more of instinctual fighting and less of the complicated and more of the simple. The more simple it is, the better off it is. It can get complicated when you start to get into the higher levels of weapons and multiple attackers, but for the most part, how do you deal with somebody right in front of you? How do you go and change you? The more aggressive, once you decide you're into violence, the more faster you attack and move to get away from the danger, the better off you are. The longer you stay engaged in the fight, the more likely you're going to take damage. So everything we teach, people, we just have a small amount of time with people, proper techniques so they know how to do something, where to hit somebody, and practice that a bunch of pads or sometimes with like contact to get that person a whole bunch of techniques or just a few techniques. And then the more you train, the more we would add to them. That all makes sense? Okay, so we'll talk about our fight stance and awareness. And fight stance for us is either you're kind of not prepared and something's happening, or you have an idea of something going on and you go, oh, stop, what are you doing? This is our fight stance. So our fight stance is very much like the stop, leave me alone, that comes out of you naturally. Most people, when they get scared, don't go to some sort of fight position. And even if I did, it takes back 5 feet, and it takes my instructor to move me. I don't know Tate, and he has that peculiar walk toward you that I know that's not right. If I went like this, stop what you want. If he's going to be aggressive, I'm actually going to give him some time to ramp up a little bit higher because I'm telegraphing that I'm ready to fight. But if I do the same thing, it's a stop what you want. This doesn't necessarily mean I'm ready to fight. I'm just as low in here as I am here with similar weapons. So we like the idea that first it's instinctual of what do you want, and then two, the ability to strike this position is pretty strong. So we're going to work on our fight stance, and our movement, which is really just about getting your feet down, hands up, just keeping your legs underneath, and keeping your balance. So are you right-handed? Dominant left-handed? Like if you got to throw a ball, how would you throw it? All right.
There's no
right side. This side doesn't work. All right. So that's fine. So you're just gonna do it. I'll go with you. So if I'm gonna be staging with you, then I'm gonna be right here so I can be on the camera. Now I'm gonna have to turn around. Turn around. Yeah, man.
Oh, you want to stare? Yeah.
That's not what I said, but that's what I wanted. So back up about 2 feet. And just walk straight ahead like you're just walking on the sidewalk. And stop with your left leg behind you. So you use your dominant leg, your left leg. And unless you walk down the hallway with the sidewalk almost like narrow, I want your feet to be hip width, just like you're normally just walking. So you're not thinking about how the width are. I don't want to pair here, because if I'm here, I'm pretty base left and right, but I'm not base front back. If I'm here, I have that base front back, but it's not side side, so I want to split that difference so that my feet are underneath me. And just like you're going to do in any sports, you get springs in your legs and you're on the ball of your feet ready to move left or right, and I want that spring to do it. So 50-50 with the weight. The back calf is kind of engaged and your back heels up a little bit. Your chin is down and your hands are up. And whatever you were afraid of, you're squared up. Now I'm going to move you a little bit. left straight out, or right about somewhere inside there. Yeah, so here now I can strike, I can grab, I can block, but I'm protecting my head the whole time. My head is just feeling like my throat. This is more comfortable when I'm it's a couple reasons. One, that will help inside there. It's the higher you are here, the easier you are to find. So you're a little bit more battle mode here. And if for some reason you get whacked in your face, this happens. And you almost like whiplash. You get dizzy sometimes by getting up too fast. I think you think you're dizzy. Step into that fight. And then you find that you see how you really right leg there. You play sports, but we're going to do a game. This far away from him. But if I'm close to him, outside of my range, close, and I compromise my balance, that moment, he can get something in. So when we try to move with our fight stance, which is when we're engaged, we're not going to cross our feet. So if I'm going to go forward and lift, I push my back foot, and I move forward. If I'm going to go backwards, I lift my back foot. Just a game of opposites. But it's how you play any sports, because you don't play, you're not here very often. So we're going to do a quick game as part of our warm up. We're not going to cross, but I don't want to risk it. Always on the outside. You're going to try to tag her, she's going to try to tag you at the same time. Whoever tags you both wins. So we're going to move around here. Let's just tag. So
I've got really long arms.
That's great. So that's just enough, but that's her world. And part of her, she has to figure out what that is. If she's going to fight somebody, everybody's big, right? So you have to figure out your range and her range so that you don't go right here, but okay, I'm safe because that's not your range. And she goes, crack. Because that's her range. So you have to learn that too.
Yeah.
So if you know, so if I'm here, you're supposed to work next, I can block.
Sure. Oh, okay.
Sure. There's no rule. Sure. Yeah, so a couple more seconds. Who joined us?
Perry.
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 All right, so quick, one more time, just for a few seconds. Now, go for the knees too. So watch. I can change the shoulder, or I can change the knees. Now you're going to change levels. Move around quick.
Okay, yeah, still
up. Sure. So, without even thinking, you never cross your feet. You're doing the exact same thing we were talking about. So that's number one. Don't overthink it. Keep your balance. Protect your head. We'll do a basic strike now. A couple of strikes. Let's go here. A little bit like this angle, I think.
What's that?
I'm just trying to see if I can move this. Yeah, there you go. I want to make sure we're all okay. So my front here, if I can do a straight putt, I can use my knuckles, which is a really good putt because it's mostly bone. But not everybody has practiced that in the wrist. So we can open our hands up and make it a little bit more general. And the heel part of your hand right here, so you have your palm, you have the heel part of your palm heel. That's the start you're going to start with. If you use your whole palm, you're going to end up straining your wrist. And you pull your fingers back, hit with that heel, and center of the pad, bring it a little top, and see what I'm going to go center of the pad with either hand. So if I find stance. I can decide that. Yes, you are. You're gonna rack. So you start with your lead arm. So you're again in our fight stance. Try not to blade. Try to keep your feet like railroad tracks, like you're walking on a sidewalk. And then bring your right in. So I'm about to. So put your right in first, and then pull that back and put your left in. And just let your body put your weight forward into the strike. But don't make it mechanical. Just make it. Just leave you alone. Yeah. Yep.
Is that okay? All
right. Hey, you should crack her a couple of times. Punch Tate a couple of times.
Really?
Yeah, punch Tate a couple of times. He likes it. Square up to him. So what's your opponent? Okay. Good. Center.
Did I get the wrong arm first?
No, well, ultimately, it doesn't matter. You give me something to start off. Dude, right there. Boom. Yeah, now. There. No, he's fine. So the next part of this is how we, when I strike, again, I'll go lefty with you. Right hand drives in, this hand stays up by the head somewhere. I fold this one back, I don't let it drop. I snap it back and recoil back above my head. Boom, boom, not here, just somewhere here. Boom, and I drop the other one back in.
Do you make noise?
All the time. Particularly in self-defense, what does a bad guy want? They want quiet to get away with it, right? So, if I'm like that, people go, what's going on? And they don't want that. Everybody goes, what? But you want to be able to, first of all, you ever had a movie that's really heavy?
Yes.
Right? Because what you really do is pushing all the air out of your muscles, you get all your muscle. So allow that to happen, and it will give you some adrenaline. You know, and I've been martial arts here, the kiosks all the time, and that is bringing in adrenaline. That's helping with the energy. Oh, well, nobody cares, but I just yelled, and nobody even looked at me. But you do whatever you gotta do. So your path will be at some point, if you're training, you try to find some way to find some noise. But just breathe. Do a couple of them. Yeah, go a little bit closer. So don't quite lean, but put your weight into it. If he moves, you move with him. And don't drop your hands. Let me have you. Let's come here. That's a piece of punch, does it?
Not quite a piece.
Well, yeah, whatever you want.
That's what I do.
Drop your elbows.
Just watch that.
There you go. Keep your elbows down.
Where are you right?
Give me a left, right? Boom, boom. Fire it.
I don't like that.
Square up. Pop up left, right? Oh, yeah. It gets physical. So breathe. That's why I was talking about water. So this is going to be all about you guys. And just breathe. You need water, get some water. You need some fresh air, or walk, pull a bathroom, get some fresh air, walk away. That's fine. Just make it about you. So, that is the beginning of the lesson, is being able to strike and be able to move a little bit. Now, we did striking in stationary, so we'll take a rest. We'll do another technique, which can be a kick. And then we're going to put them together. And you'd be surprised at how comfortable it is and how natural it just kind of feels. So in Krav Maga, there's no rules of self-defense. So if I was to attack you and I was going to try to harm you, you could kick me in the groin, you could take your thumb into my eyeballs, you could bite my ear off. All those things that sound like, oh, I could never do that, then you realize that there's evil things happening if you don't do something aggressive. you're going to have bad things, right? And your job is to go home to your family. So our motto is to go home safely. So it takes away the reward. He's attacking me. He's trying to just choke me, whatever. He's not a victim. If I start to get the upper hand on him, he's not a victim. He's still the bad guy. I'm just winning. Right? So you can't put him, I could never do that to this guy because I'm too nice. At some point, you may have to do some awful things just to go home to your family. And I'm not saying to be awful, you don't have to. Like, you know, if he bumps into you, just walk by and bump. He doesn't need that. You know, he doesn't need that because he bumped into me. I was like, lady, I just hit you. I'm sorry. I was on the sidewalk. I was on my phone. Somebody was like, some old lady just beat me up. I can't get up. You know, these things happen. But we also don't have the door. So you have it inside you. It's just, that's right. So we can access it. The whole idea of training is to be able to access what you need and not try to figure out, is this real? Am I really in danger? Why is this happening? Why? Well, it doesn't really matter. It's that attack or something is dangerous happening. You're addressing that danger. Doing enough? Too much? That's not self-defense. Not enough. Started something that you should have finished, and now you're probably going to get it worked because you're stuck in the middle of something. So one of our strikes is kick the groin. It's very signature. It's not fair. It's not allowed in ring fighting because it's dirty. But the truth is, it's a dirty look. If I go to it, what works? Kicks to the groin, kicks to the knee to cause damage, and to his throat. All those things, but it's very hard. Yeah, it's very hard. I feel like I could never do anything, but really, honestly, the idea is a little damage if possible. Here, right about inside there. I'm up. Just up, drive. That's pretty good. Right back down. And the idea is you want to drive up off the ground with your leg. My knees slightly above the target. My leg can snap out. And then I'm going to bring it right back down. My foot, so I can move it back. Moving it. If one strike's probably going to be enough. So you should. When I kick, my shoelaces come together, or that instep, or my shin, if it gets any closer, then there's my shoelaces, there's my instep, there's my shin. Same strike, just getting closer with range. I want you to focus where your shoes tie into your feet. Yeah, how far away you are. Range is good too, I like range. But let's kick with your instep right through here. And we're going to put that right in the center of the pad. And just try to kick the pad out of his knee. So he's going to set with you. You've done this before. Oh, don't worry. Just kick. Yeah, don't overthink it. Just kick. Back up a little bit. Your little long legs are not very good.
So my legs will be straight.
I want you to bend your knees slightly above the target and try to get your legs straight.
Yeah,
back up a little bit. Kick in. So don't just be here. Be. Just like try to kick as hard as you want. If you got to kick the pad over the ceiling, how would you do that? That's the kick. Don't overthink it. Just kick. The more you push off the floor with that calf muscle, the more power it'll have. Ah, that was a good one. How'd that feel? Like? Yeah. I give you a good kick.
That was good.
So move around a little bit, hands up. Take a breath, and I'll talk for a second. Our eyes help us with our self-defense. If I'm staring, if I'm fighting tape, if I'm fighting tape and I do something like this, my eyes, whether I'm going to go for the knees or the groin thread, if I look where I'm going, it's a telegraph. It will tell him something is up there. But that's part of it. And also, if I'm looking here, I'm not going to kick past that. I'm going to kick to that spot. So to cause damage, part of that damage is penetrating the target. I don't punch him in the nose to stop at the surface of it. I want to punch the middle of his head to cause damage, right? You ever had your nose in the surface? I made contact with the nose down, right? If I'm inside there, now if I have that really hard side behind it, that damage is going to cause, or that penetration, it's going to lead to damage. And we need damage for them not to come after us. Right? Violence, if violence is happening, violence is the answer. If I hadn't gone to talk my way out of it or run, I should have done that. When the point starts to get where I'm engaging, or he's attacking, then I need to use violence to stop that. And my violence needs to be stronger than his violence. You had a 50-foot, right? Be quiet out there! Well, in karate, I like all of our arts. I really do. I think there's fascinating parts to all of them. But they're not all practical. Some of you have kind of been a lifetime martial artist.
I know, I sound like a martial
artist. Right, so you had a 50-foot, right? The problem about 50-foot. What works for you? I can't do that. Well, don't do that. Let's figure out something else that works. We figure out two of the rules that really work well. There's all the bodies you can practice is better than one big tool box.
Why did I
hear a
box?
Sure. So a good kick, a good stop, a good kick, run like hell. That's a good self-defense box. What you want to do is you want to do enough damage that they don't want to come after you, or they can't come after you. And then you just want to get to safety, whatever that is. Now, safety being, you know that door leads to your car, and then you're pretty much wide open. You may not know, unless you're familiar with this area, that you go that way, you might be stuck in a room. So if I start to attack you, you're able to defend, not only improve your position by getting away from me, but improve your position and move towards safety, if you know. Is that way, you're not sure that way, so that way's more safe for you, but you know that. Yeah, and end up in a grabbing a door to enter the closet. It's like, well, great. Yeah, now things fall. So those things happen, so you want to move towards safety as well as your position. So now we're going to put them together. I want to do the picture of the drawing. And a couple of palm strikes, and we're going to move around just a little bit. So, all that means is I'm in my fight stance. I can be passive and step into my fight stance and get to it, I think something happens. Throw one kick and two palm strikes, and I want you to keep your hands up, and I just want you to move around like you did in tag. Okay? So, here. Strike. Move around. That's it. But you can do the exact same thing. You'll look just as amazing. Jake loves to be hit. We were in Cambodia one time with a whole group of people all at the same time. He got whooped a little bit. And the entire group at the same time said, he's fine. It was a moment in my head of, I hope I can keep the one forever.
Yeah.
So, same drill, fight stance. Throw your kick. Get your balance. You'll be at different ranges because your legs are longer. Move in if you need to. Throw a couple punches. And then just move around. Then give me a kick. Move around. You'll find left, right, and faster. One, two. Good. Good. All right, rest. Put back over. Let's pause that. Let's take 2 minutes. Just a pressure. Do you want to pause that?
That's okay.
Take 2 minutes. Space out. Keep it out. Don't do the pressure.
Well, the truth is, I talked about that. My first newsletter was long-term to happen. You know, people that I can't pray for that. You do drills, and I have these weeks where I'll be able to find it. And this is just not an uncomfortable thing to do. It's just reality. But we're trying to be able to pick it up. Stuck with my old friend, but if I take this hand, if I have my hand, I can make that happen too. Nothing fancy. It might be a little bit more dangerous if you're on my throat. I'm going to take this off and get a good spot. He grabbed onto my throat. Now, this is somebody who's up, so he's a choke from the side. And this is the danger. This is a helper, but I don't need to worry about this hand nearly as much as I need to worry about this one. So I have a normal response to pain. So if I want to pinch your leg, put it in your hand. Yeah, you go right to where that pain is, you stop that, right? It's not hurt, it's not science, it's like, that hurts, stop it. So our answer to our pain is long before we think about it. It's a surprise that happens. You drive me aggressively, my hands are going to do this because this is a surprise and I don't like it. It's painful. And if it starts to compromise my breathing, I have that much more incentive to get it off so I can breathe. So I don't have to think about that, like, oh, he's choking, I should do something. My hands are going, we're doing something already. Right. So we're going to use that as a technique. I talk about Krav Maga using instincts or reflex. When pain happens, our hands tend to go to that pain. So if he's choking me, I send my hand up there and I just clear. So the only technique I'm doing is I'm really ripping the jab. Yeah. 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 We're just going to. Yeah.
see where the thumb is? It's the same. It's the same weak spot, right? And I could do. Maybe I could put a striking. But if he's striking me, grabbing on, I have a pretty small clock. And it's hard to override this urge to go where the pain is to think about that or this hurts. It's possible. But if I could address the danger quickly and then start the counter strike before he realizes what's happening, that moment surprises your best friend. Particularly your side, right? If I'm attacking you, your surprise is your best friend. It's not how strong you're going to be, where you strike it, how you strike it, that's going to be part of it. But your ability to land them and surprise me is better. And the more you telegraph, I'm going to do something, the more I'm preparing for it, the harder that's going to be. So if he grabs onto me and I rip inside here, now, here's the other fun part of this. For him to be aggressive, what does aggressive look like? If you had to describe aggressive, what would it be? Would it be here? Would this be aggressive? Would this be aggressive? Yeah, I want to be larger than life, but I want to be intimidating. So the chest expands, the hips come forward. And if you ever have lifting heavy, you don't stand back and lift up. You get close to it, right? So he grabs onto me. He wants that power. He's going to be close, and where the hips going to be at? You're being fairly close, too. So I address the danger. Maybe I can hang out. Maybe not. But I go past. I use momentum, not strength, but momentum. And you clear that. Now I start to strike the groin, and I start to hit the head. He's going, this isn't fair. And I'm going to run to say, one of these strikes probably won't be enough. But you just have to figure out what's happening in that moment. So I will teach you techniques. And then based on his response, is what you're going to do. So we're going to work on this toe movement. We're going to go to the front. Too strong, or he's pushing me to lose my balance, then I just use rotational force. But this happens either because this fails, but it can happen this way. Here, I could do that too. This is very successful, but it's not quite as instinctual as a pinion. So we had both for a toolbox. So those are choke defenses with a pluck or with a rotation. Let's pick one. Let's do, what scares you more, being here or being surprised? All right, so turn around. Hey, what's going to happen is this. I'm going to come up here. I need to stay here. So turn around so you can watch me. He's going to surprise me. He's going to grab my throat. He's going to give me a little bit of a push. I'm going to step and find my balance. I'm going to stab this arm up. Whatever leg is closest to him, and just turn around. What makes this work is watch his hands. Okay? You see where my shoulder stabs up? I actually trap his knuckles with my shoulder, then all of my entire body works against his little wrist right there. So I just turn around, which is you're going to want to do that anyway. Right? So if you face that way and I tap your shoulder, I scare you, what are you going to do? You're going to turn around. What's going on? Right? So he's going to. So you guys can work with her. I'm gonna work with you right here on the channel. So you turn around. Have you done this one? All right. So take a step. Okay. Well, yeah. But I want to take a step. Find your balance. So opposite. Yeah. Take a step. Good. Now stab this arm up. Stab. Up, stab. Stab. Stab straight up. Now. Yeah. That. So the more your shoulder is on my knuckles, the more your core of your body works against my wrist. The lower your hand is, the more it gets on this, the more muscle it takes. Possible, but more hard. Okay. So the more you stab your arm up, stab it up. I want you to think about this stab.
Okay.
That. So you can go right here, right?
Yeah.
That's what happens here. So that's the beginning of it. I'm gonna come and take your spot for the ceiling. And I stitch. Whatever they pull, it doesn't matter. You need to find yourself in some position where you find it like a balance. Maybe it'd be two or three steps before you find the balance, right? So just like it's four, here's their hook. Do I turn on three more this way or do I go three more this way? Where are we getting that to turn up? Before you turn up. Turn all the way around. And now, at that point, you can fight. So, what I want you to do is turn up. Yes, See the camera right about there. So you turn around. He's going to choke you. He's going to do your defense. Turn around and you're going to face me. Do that same kick. Follow my kickball trick. So just like you did with the same attacker, but that's right. So here you go. And then face me, and then kick, and then punch, and then move on. And that's the beginning of the drill. So what you've done in one 45-minute time is taking your head and I can do something. Number one is the power to do something. Second thing is, mechanically, it's not complicated, but it makes sense. Now you're going to put those together.
I'm not going to have
to think. That's the only reason I can do this. That's the only reason. My mom said, you don't think well, but you look well. So it just worked out well. So we did it one more time. Then we're going to do it with you a couple times. And the idea is, you're a little surprised and a little bit of stress. Do the defense. Find me. Do a kick. Double pops with the palm stretch. Keep your hands up. And then kind of skirt the area a little bit while you're supposed to do what's happening. Because awareness is a really big part of yourself. There you go, right here. Yep. Now move around. Yeah, it's a good stretch. Keep going, keep it. Now. Hands up, move like this. You just move right here. Just like it. That's it. And what you're doing is you're standing. Just do those. But you want to exist this drill because you want to do this. But later on, you want to get out of the middle. So there's a side list that you can more advanced list. If I have a people, don't be there. To the one side of somebody and find them. You're doing one person. That's great.
Alex, fine.
So, you're basically, you can easily surprise you. Do your defense. Find me, deliver it. Kick to the groin, get two palm strikes. Keep your hands up and move around. Good job. Hands up. Kick. Now we're gonna do the same drill. I'm gonna keep her engaged a little bit doing this. She's working with me. She's by the shoulder. She can't still do that and then go back to me. So now you're doing the same drill for me. So, I'm on camera, I'm sorry, but that was great. You'd be surprised. Watching is actually harder than actually doing. It's physical. But in the moment, you'll just do it. And you got to breathe. And you work your conditioning. So that is that's a micro lesson. Which if you came to class, this would be a typical class for us. With, 10 people. But we teach light sense of movement in almost every level one class. Foundation.
No, I wish I had a
coach with this. My wife has a coach. Oh, I'm sure. She's much older than I am. She's 78, but she's. I told her, I said, she would be interested, and I all of them. Well, I have a student who's 74 and 75 soon, and you would never know. But, the bottom line is, he knows he's more of a category of somebody you're targeting. You wanted to have a couple too. We should all
learn. I feel really good. Like I will never be on.
We are so distracted, with the phones, parking lots, groceries, everything else. If the people doing their job who are the predators, away from you being that distracted. They want the easy attack, right? They don't want a fair fight. But they want to have an easy attack. Isolated, distracted, small, weak, bigger, whatever. It's all about them going to fuck. And your job is recognizing it. And if earlier you recognize, the more options you'll have. If I recognize Tate's the bad guy at 20 feet, I have more options of recognizing when he got his hands on me at 1 foot.
You're just going to stay on super surprise stance.
And it's so big. If I go,
you'll bring your hands up. You use this right here. It's like, Jesus, what?
That was the thing my mom was like, wrong. But that surprise is exactly what happens. It's that, what is it? Oh, you know, and that's why it works for us. And we train from writing, because from sitting in the chair, you have to get up, even like to begin the bed with blankets on. How do you deal with that? The blankets are a handicap. You have to get past it. But when you get down to the basic toolbox, you're applying those tools and you start to get different positions. The goals are the same. Address the danger, improve your position, or two. When Amy put the system together, we have, Amy was really good at expressing things. And one of his signature lines was that we're probably going to have something to want. You know what to do a little bit. You're not so scared. And something happens. That's really what we do. So that's great. This is probably a good spot to wrap that.
Yeah, all right.
And the problem is just not really good.
I know, I am.
These things are, every year is a little bit different. Well, we didn't do it last year. Yeah, no,
release? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about risk releases. So there's a couple of variety of positions. Commonly, let's say you go here, so I just grab on. Again, that's weak spot. So what do I need to do? She doesn't even know this technique, she knows exactly what I can do. That's the technique right there. So it's, if I take my elbow towards his elbow, it's all the, there's an elbow there or there. What I'm not doing, I'm not pulling my hand. A lot of mistakes people do is something like this. It works a lot, but if you have to go with me, then I run into one of the tips. Right? So if I take my elbow, if my elbow's touching his elbow, like something like that, he's not going to grab on. Right? So he grabs on, I just drive that. He cross grabs, where's that weak spot? Then the elbow goes forward, and back. This is more restraining. This is a little more respectful.
Yeah, no,
and then if I grab here, you already saw the 2-on-1 where I just take the fifth and I just pull against the front. So those are the common wrist releases. So you go there, I'll go here. And if I'm grabbing you here, take your elbow, try to make your arm parallel to mine. See what happens to my grip? Even if I can do that, you snap it fast. That's right, works. Now, I will go back in a second and talk about what happens. Can't be out of this, it's just so strong. We'll talk about this. So, put this here. Don't pull away. Take your elbow towards mine. Yeah.
Now I have to move my leg.
Yeah, or just lean into it.
Okay.
Here. If not, don't step. Now just push over. Don't step. Now grab onto mine. Be a little bit more like this. Less. There you go. Now if I grab you cross, that's it. And then you give, take a hard step and rip your arm, do that. You can do that too. Or just take one, just step back and just rip. Just take a step. Cross your foot. And just do it, like, give your arm back. Right? When they do that, that's what you normally do, right? They're trying to control you a little bit. Down and out back of my face. Right? Yeah, because I'm trying to do something, you want your hands back. Right. Yeah, up. Two on one, like a fish, grab it. That's it. That's the beginning of all of that.
That's fine.
Sure. Then you're just working. Yeah. Like, don't do it again. Like, no. But there is time when you're degrading or grab on. Yeah. So you get elbow, head foot, butt, jump. Well, then you have to, generally when they grab onto your leg, you should be able to get back. The one thing about ripple is we call them soft. We don't necessarily know that, so take him over here. Let's say he just grabbed me, he wants to show me something. He might not need to be punched in the head, right? He goes, oh, come here, I don't want you to step on the wet paint, right? So if I'm going to do that, and he just painted, he grabbed me, don't step on the wet paint, he may not need to be blown up. He might, but. So we don't necessarily know his intentions, but if I can get him back fairly easily, his intentions are what? Probably more bad. So I do want my hands back. It is a natural response. So put your hand up for me. If I grab your hand, that's your natural response. Because we don't like that, right? So if we get our hands back, then, but if we're so strong by your hand, we need to say, oh, I'm in danger because we treat him like danger. So really strong. So soft techniques when we don't necessarily know his intentions. But once it's clear, then we take that appropriate action. Soft could be like, oh, I won't step on your paint.
Or, well, I noticed you.
Yeah, she's comfortable. Yeah. She's got little meat. And her punches will hurt because they're little small spots like that.
Yeah.
And they'll fit right into those spots.
Yeah, those small fits
hurt. Yeah. They'll do, that's great. It'll, I love that. It's that spirit. I'm going to be hard with you. This is not going to be easy. You know, and if you think I got to go home, he's in my way before he goes, and he's trying to harm me. Not a victim, because he's choosing to do evil. And then you're going to behave yourself enough to deal with that to go home safely. Can't come back and punish, although I think you should be able to. But you can't. You can do enough to get away from it. How you express what I have to do, the same person what I have to say. I may not do the same.
I grabbed you. I did a bad job. You broke my arm! And I picked on you.
What did you learn, sir? So, we just take that aggressive behavior, but at the same time, often you can avoid it by just paying attention. Right? It's a surprise they're looking for to give them the big attention. Not be surprised when they're out there. Keep your head up, pay attention. If it looks dangerous, trust your instincts. God knows you're out there. Listen to that sense. And if that sense says, hey, this isn't good, regardless of what it looks like, go somewhere safe. You're safe. That's the whole idea. If you can avoid the fight, that's the best. So that is a microlist of the problem of God, but it's very much like a classic.
Thank you very much.
I want to see a recording. Are you still recording?
No, yeah. Okay.
Did
thank
you
very much. Yeah. Thank you for joining us. Thank you very much.
Make me look skinny.
Have a great evening.